everyone. So this is the summary of the poem Breaking Out by Marge Piercy. These are the important points about this poem. This poem was published in 1984. This poem is about a little girl who gets mistreated in her house by her parents. This girl imagines to grow up and run away from this house as she can't bear this oppression. She doesn't like her mother doing the same household chores every day like sweeping and cleaning. She thinks that her mother is a slave of her husband. This girl doesn't want to become like her mother. She hates these household chores which her parents force her to do. She has read in a school about the myth of Sisyphus, who was punished by God Zeus to roll a rock up to the hill from where it rolls back down. He was punished to do this meaningless task for eternity. This girl thinks that her mother's work is also meaningless like Sisyphus. She wants to break out from the clutches of the patriarchal society to live an independent and free life. Her first act of defiance happens at the age of 11 when she breaks the stick which her parents used to beat her brutally. She feels empowered after this incident. So this is the text of the poem. My first political act, I am seeing two doors that usually stood open, leaning together like gossips making a closet of their corner. So the opening lines mean her defiance against the authority and tyranny of her parents. So at the age of 11, this girl breaks the stick with which her parents beat her. Okay. And she wants to get free and liberated. She observes the doors leaning against each other as if they are gossiping about this girl and are keeping an eye upon this girl. So here the doors are personified as two persons who are gossiping about this girl's activities. Come to the next lines. A mangle stood there for ironing, but I never thought needed it. Sheets, towels, my father's underwear. So now this girl notices a washing machine lying at the corner of the house, which washes and irons clothes like bed sheets, towels, her father's underwear. So these clothes which don't need ironing, according to the girl. So in the next lines, so these are the next lines. An upright vacuum with its stuffed sausage bag that deflated with a gusty sigh, as if weary of housework as I, who swore I would never dust or sweep. After I left home, who hated to see my mother removing daily the sludge, the air laid down like a snail's track. So in these lines, she observes a vacuum cleaner standing in a corner with its sausage bag in which vacuum cleaner collects dust. Okay, sausage bag is a bag in which vacuum cleaner collects dust. So while cleaning, this vacuum cleaner makes a loud sound as if it is also tired and exhausted like the girl of doing the same works every day. Okay. So now this girl swears that she will never do cleaning and sweeping when she grows up. Okay. And in the next line she says that whenever she goes out for school, she feels bad to see her mother doing the same work of cleaning the dust every day. And she compares her mother with Sisyphus, who was punished to roll a rock up to the hill repeatedly. And she thinks that her mother's work is as useless as that of Sisyphus. So she sees her mother cleaning the dust coming from the factories by sitting on her knees. Okay, see these lines. So that when in school I read of Sisyphus and his rock, it was her and I thought of housewife scrubbing on raw knees as the factory rained ash. So her mother cleans the dust coming from the factories by sitting on her knees. And girl feels bad to see her mother doing the same task every day. And she thinks that this task is useless and meaningless. Okay. Come to the next lines. Next is talking of hobnobbing. Doors was a wooden yardstick dusty with chalk marks from Ham's rise and fall. So in these lines, you know, this girl observes a yardstick. Yardstick is a measuring rod and compares it with stork king. Stork is a bird which has a long beak. Similarly, this yardstick is also long. And she notices the chalk marks and dust on this rod. Okay. Come to the next line. When I had been just truly waked, that stick was the tool of punishment. I was beaten as I bellowed like a locomotive, as if noise could ward off blows. So in these lines, the girl says that she is beaten by the same yardstick by her parents when she does something mischievous and when she refuses to work. So when she is beaten brutally by this rod, then she cries loudly like a train's engine. And she thinks that her loud cries would make her escape from those blows. Come to the next lines. My mother wielded it more fiercely, but my father far longer and harder. I would twist my head in the mirror to inspect. Now she says that her mother beats her strongly, but her father's blows are harder and he beats her for a long time. So she turns her head towards the mirror to check her wounds. Come to the next lines. I would study those red and blue mountain ranges as on a map that offered escape. The veins and arteries, the roads I could travel to freedom when I grew. Okay. And now she says that she checks the marks of these wounds, okay, in the mirror. And she compares the marks of these blows with red and blue mountains, showing her a map to escape from this house. And she notices the roads on the maps and thinks that these roads will make her escape from this pain and suffering, okay, when she grows up. Come to the next lines. When I was 11, after a beating, I took the ruler and smashed it to kindling. Fingering the splinters, I could not believe. How could this road prove weaker than me? It was not that I was never again beaten, but in destroying the stick that has measured my pain, the next day I was an adolescent, not a child. Okay, so in these lines, the girl says that when she becomes 11 years old, she gathers up courage and strength and breaks the road with which she has been beaten so cruelly for so long. Okay. And this road symbolizes the oppression and tyranny of her parents. And she feels so surprised that how could she break such a strong road? And she has destroyed the stick which has given her a lot of pain and trauma. So after destroying this road, she feels that she is no longer a child and she is a responsible girl now. Okay? This is not a tale of innocence lost but power gained. I would not be Sisyphus. There were things that I should learn to break. And now she says that she feels that she is no longer a child and she is a responsible girl now. She believes in her internal strength and courage and she says that she won't become Sisyphus. So she won't become like her mother, but she will learn to defy anything which will curb her freedom, okay, which will destroy her freedom. And here the poem ends.